about 3 miles.
New Carlisle Council Meeting, Monday, December 7th, 2015, 7 p.m. Please call to order. Roll call, Mr. Collier.
Mayor McLaughlin.
Here.
Mr. McIntyre.
Here.
Mr. Zambach.
Present.
Mr. Reynolds.
Here.
Mr. Rick Lowry.
Here.
Mr. Kraybacher.
Here.
Mr. Mike Lowry.
Here.
Thank you.
All present.
Thank you, sir. Before we continue on, a couple of things. Welcome everybody here this evening. If you have a cell phone, if you would mind turning it off or put it on vibrate, please, so it doesn't interrupt the meeting. And I would also say, please remember, today's December the 7th, Pearl Harbor Day. Remember that, please. We had 2,400. Today, that's what I said. Today, December the 7th, today. You should remember that. And now, if you'll join me and stand up, we'll have an invocation by Mr. McIntyre.
Let us pray. Lord, we enter the Christmas season, a time when we reflect on peace on earth and goodwill to men. Unfortunately, the world we live in today is filled with war and rumors of war. We're blessed here that we can have this beautiful democracy in a peaceful part of the world. But we know that it's not the case in the rest of the world, that there is a lot of conflict. And as Christ was born to make man holy, let us also strive to make people free, particularly those who are living under the cruel regimes in places like Syria or have to endure the attacks like what we saw in Paris and California. Let's hope that as we enter the new year, we become a more peaceful place where we can all enjoy the gifts and the blessings that we have right here in New Carlisle. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. You'll join me for the pledge, please. We use the flag in the back. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. May I have action on the minutes of the regular meeting of November 16, 2015?
So moved.
Second.
Did you get that, Mr. Dollar?
It scared me, but I got it. Second by Mr. Reynolds.
Mr. Collier, if you call for the vote.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Kraybacher?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Seven oh passed, I take it? Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Communications, are there any tonight?
None this evening, sir.
No communications. Thank you. We're now going to the city manager's report.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of council, members of the public, citizens. I'd like to share with you the city manager's report. We're just going to jump on down to fire discussion. The Elizabeth Township contract, they will sign after January 1st, 2016. I think they're waiting for the results of the fire chief. And also, they have a new trustee going to be sworn in after the first, so I think they just want him to be part of that. So again, they will sign after January 1st of next year. And moving on to bullet point number two is Mr. Chief Trustee has been selected as the new fire minister slash chief, so I would like him to just step up and give his formal hello and maybe discuss a little bit what his plans are.
Good evening. First of all, I'd like to thank the Lord for the blessing of the position, and thank the city for the privilege and the chance to serve the city of New Carlisle. Looking forward to it. It's exciting, a little nervous, not going to lie. But what we're looking forward to in the immediate future, we're looking at this, taking this as a new beginning for the department and moving forward in a lot of different areas. Right now, we are still hiring. Every week, it seems like we're bringing on at least one or two more people. We brought on two more paramedics this past week. We're bringing on another paramedic and two EMTs this week, building our roles up to cover the part-time slots, and also bringing some of those people are, two out of the three are in the area, in the immediate response area, so they'll be able to respond also as first responders on pay-per-call. 60 to 90 day plan is to do a little bit of restructuring with the officers' ranks because we are right now shy two captains, so I need to promote two people into those positions. And usually moving someone into a captain's position, probably coming out of a lieutenant's position, so backfilling into those positions also. Reaching out to the other departments in the area to look at them and to see what we can do together as a combined effort for training for the division and the surrounding area working together. Because in the situations that we're in, when we have a structure fire, all the departments are going to be there. It's not just going to be us or them. We're all working together. And I don't want our people to be the first time they see their apparatus or them vice versa with the other departments. And I've already reached out to two of the different departments, and they're more than willing and looking forward to doing the same. So, any
Council, questions? Any questions for the chief, please? Anyone?
I'd just like to wish you luck.
Thank you, sir.
Think you can do the job.
Anyone else? Council? I do have a couple of questions, Chief.
Yes, sir.
If you would, apparatus, are we all right with apparatus at this point?
Yes, sir.
And staffing, I mean, we're adequate at this point, and are you bringing on more people?
We're bringing on more people. We're adequately standing. We're not down, or we're open holes, or not filling a shift, or anything like that. We're covered.
Yeah. Well, welcome aboard. And thank you for being here. And,
thank you.
And all the luck in the world, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. And moving on, just under the police discussion, I do have a little blurb about the sheriff's contract. I did reach out to Chief Doyle Wright last week. The contract is currently in review with the Clark County Prosecutor's Office. So as soon as they have that back, hopefully, likely, it will be on the next agenda as an emergency ordinance. Now, but again, we're just waiting for their law department to approve that. And informational items, attached in the city manager report, you'll see a letter that I sent to Clark County Commissioners asking for $12,500 for a Parks and Recreation update. So I will have a status on that as soon as we hear back from that. But I think it's a good time to reach out to our county commissioners and ask for just a little bit of their money to help improve some of the facilities that we have here. And also, too, attached with the city manager's report is a TCC appointment and one alternative needed. So hopefully the council had a minute to look over that email and then also look at the letter that Scott Smith had sent me. But basically, TCC is the Transportation Coordinating Committee. Mayor McLaughlin currently goes, and I attend with him. They are doing a restructuring to where it's going to be split out, but they still need one member of council to show up at the meetings and then one alternative. So I do believe that takes a motion amongst themselves to vote who goes into that. I do believe, Mr. Mayor, you're willing to, again.
I'm willing to continue on. I know it's tough for schedules of people if they're working and so forth to be able to do that, but I would be willing to serve if you would like me to continue to serve. I've done it for the last 4 years. I find it interesting. It takes a good half or three quarters of your day, to be honest with you. And I would be willing to do it again if you would like me to at that point.
Mr. Mayor,
yes, sir.
I make a motion to appoint you to the 13th CC board.
Second.
Who is going to be the alternate?
Well, we're going to have to ask that at this point. If we, it's finding an alternate sometimes is tough. I know before Mr. McIntyre was, but again, with his work schedule, it was tough. But I didn't miss any meetings either.
Right. Well, I'd like to be the alternate.
Would you like to be the alternate?
Yeah.
Would you like to amend your?
Certainly, he can just add to it.
John Craybacher being the alternate.
Okay.
If I have to add to my second, I will.
You just did. Yeah.
So would you like to read it as you have it now, please, sir?
Motion to appoint Lowell McLaughlin to the TCC board, and in the motion, I'll spell that out.
Okay.
And Mr. Craybacher as the alternative for 2016.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Who's the current alternative?
Was Mr. McIntyre was, but again,
okay.
Didn't happen.
But he works.
Is there any conversation, any survey else on that? Okay, if you call for the vote, please.
Give me 2 seconds here.
Sure. Take your time.
Mr. Reynolds.
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. Craybacher.
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry.
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin.
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre.
Yes.
Mr. Zambon.
Yes.
Pass 7-0.
Just to let everybody know on that Transportation Coordinating Committee, that's how we get the grants, that's how we got the lights up and down Main Street, and there are different surveys that they've done for us and so forth. It's, we need to have people there to be representing New Carlisle, because if we're not, there'll be monies and situations that we may not get at that point, and grants. So just to let everyone know.
And TCC is also seeking an appointment for what they are doing, it's called a Technical Advisory Committee. So me and Mr. Kiko will decide between either him or myself to be a member of the Technical Advisory Committee. So therefore, how it's going to play out is we'll have an elected representative on their board and then a person of administration on their advisory committee for their planning and engineering and stuff like that too. So we'll have a representation at all levels.
Thank you. Anything else in the city manager's report?
And I do believe that's all we have for this council meeting city manager report, so we open any questions.
Any questions for the city manager? Anyone? Oh, yes, sir. Go ahead, please.
Okay. I have a couple questions.
Sure.
I'm sure it's going to stir some controversy, but we need to talk about it. We need to talk about it. Randy, you just said that the Sheriff's Department will be talking about the Sheriff's Department contract. We went?
As soon as I get back from then.
And how many deputies is that
for? It's for three.
We need one more.
Okay. We already had a work session on it.
Okay. Well, look, we haven't settled that.
Mr. Lowry, will you speak up so we can
sure,
all hear you?
Absolutely.
Sometimes it's hard to hear you. I'm sorry.
I apologize.
Sure.
We had a work session on it. Yes, we did. We never came to a conclusion. We talked about a part-time deputy.
Well, I said that we're going to start with three and work our way up as the year goes on. Is exactly how that work session came out.
Okay, but that was never set in stone.
It was set in stone, which we left. I was under the impression, I think other council members, correct me if I'm wrong, that we're starting with three and reanalyzing as we go on.
Okay.
That
didn't
would include possibly sharing a Bethel Township.
Okay, level. And that's what I got out of it, was mm-hmm. three and possibly sharing one. I'm talking about a fourth deputy, four full deputies.
Sure.
Okay, is that going to happen?
We'll have to probably have another work session. I think that we should probably wait and see how the dump's going to come along after the first of the year with our police levy.
Do we have any more information on the police levy? How much money can we generate?
I think we're still current as of last report, which was about 30,000, because she hasn't closed for November yet.
Okay.
Yeah. But if we as a council, or if you as a council, wants to reopen that, I have no problem doing it.
Okay.
I think we should still stick with the starting off with three, see how that dump comes in.
Okay. And I agree with three, but I thought at mm-hmm. the work session it was more or less, as an afterthought, mm-hmm. we said, okay, we're going to try three and a half. And I can't go along with it.
Okay.
Okay.
Sure. Not a problem, sir.
Okay.
Mr. Reckless, you had a question?
During the special meeting, we did vote to approve three, right, with the potential for right. a fourth one.
The motion was to establish a contract for three to
yep.
start 2016.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
See
with the consideration of
the fourth.
Bethel Township and mm-hmm. discussions related to.
Because if we bring in that 500,000, then we can look at possibly either getting our fourth on our own or adjusting that to share the deputy on come at a total of four in a different way, but. You know, as of right now, we're sticking with three. Seeing how that dump comes in.
Yeah, let me just
then we can reanalyze and re-have another work session.
If I may interject here, we have our finance director. We keep throwing that figure of $500,000 out. Is that a realistic figure?
We talked about 400 for the 0.5%. 450, and it's slow coming in, but we want to make sure that we have the funds before we obligate. And I do believe in that new contract that it was a lot more expensive than what it was before a couple years ago. So there's a lot mm-hmm. of issues, and we talked about doing a conservative what we have available to start out with, and then reevaluate. You can always add, but it's really hard to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just wanted to make that point. That figure's been thrown around a lot. At 500,000, everyone was under the impression that at the first of the year we were going to have $500,000 to be able to spend on debt. That's not true. I mean, the money is not even going to be coming in that strong until after tax period, which is not until April. Is that correct?
Basically, yes. The first
quarter
of next year.
I just want everyone to be aware of that. So when we start saying we need to add, and I agree that it would be nice to be able to do that, but we need to have the money to be able to do that. So I want to make that point. It's your turn, sir.
Yeah, I just basically was going to just copy what you just said, because, you know, to stress that it doesn't just show up, you know, we've got to wait till tax season, so you already covered it, so I don't need to say it again. But the other thing is when you guys were asking about the fourth, it was at that meeting, it was just basically we need to decide what the best combination was for that fourth deputy. Was it to flat out hire the fourth on our own, or was it to split one with Bethel and then do, you know, shared hours with the, you know, overtime hours, whatever it may be. But yeah, that's pretty much what it was. Just finding that perfect combination that suits our financial well-being and
Mr. Craybacher, you
okay? If you remember, I mentioned the fourth deputy because we had to vote, bring back our deputies, you know, which was four deputies. And also mentioned, you know, that Kim Jones said 500,000 is what we would generate, and you presented us what I thought probably was more the better figure.
Well, it's a conservative estimate, one, and unless you're bringing over $1 million in income tax, you're not going to get $500,000.
Well,
so,
well, we're a retirement community, and mm-hmm. to tell you, like, we get older, and there's a lot of retirement sure. money that is not being taxed. But I thought we ended the meeting with kind of a compromise with three deputies, do part time, and Nancy Brown had to go to the trustees sure. to see about.
Yep.
To see, and I think that's how we Indeed. Ended it, you know. Because I would like you, Rick, I'd like to have four too.
Well, another thing we need to realize too is we need to save some of this money.
And that's what you said.
Yeah, I mean, we got equipment we need to buy, we got capital things that we need to buy. We need to stock away some money that if year six this levy doesn't pass, we're not caught with our pants down and we have a little bit of money to have police officers. So there's a lot that we have to do in these next 5 years with these right. funds. You know, so we have to analyze what's the best route to go. You know, I think that once we have a better understanding of exactly how much money we're going to bring in, and we did have a change of tax administrator, so hopefully that helps out some too with bringing additional revenue in. But, you know, again, until we have that solid picture of what we're bringing in, I think we're doing a good thing. Start off with three, and then we'll open to reanalyze as it comes in.
All right, Mr. Zambach, would like to have comments.
Just a quick arithmetic review for all of us. Number one, if this levy of a 0.5% additional generates $400,000 a year, it will only generate $200,000 for the second half of 2015 this year. It will take us until this coming April to realize that $200,000. If it in fact generates a full $400,000, it will be April of 2017 before the city actually receives the money. So how much we're going to have at any given moment is unsure. The one thing we know beyond a shadow of a doubt, we will not have $400,000 available right now to spend. It just isn't there. Another factor we must consider, we don't know how much the deputies are going to cost us next year. We got a pretty good idea, but we don't know. So, two financial variables. We don't know how much money we're going to have, and we don't know how much of that money we don't know we're going to have to spend. It's very hard to make a hard plan to hire four deputies on our own next year if we don't know how much four it costs and we don't know how much we're going to have, other than we know pretty much for sure we won't have enough income next year from that levy. So it's going to be a gradual process, as everybody has said. Immediately go to three, and as soon as we can, increase our deputy force. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. McIntyre.
To piggyback off of Mr. Zambach's second point, do we have any idea what the increase approximately, because I don't think the numbers are out, the increase of a deputy cost from last time to now, how the increase in price for
that was all presented at the work session. I don't have those notes.
Don't have that.
Yeah.
Okay.
It wasn't too much of an increase.
I think
when Mr. Zambach says that it's unknown, we have a general idea how much it costs, but we don't know how much health insurance is going to cost, and that's the big kicker.
So it's four. I think that the number just said was about 4,000 to 6,000, and I don't have the paperwork in front of me here.
Sure. Well, but a lot of it too is around health insurance. So I think if we're a single person, it's 8,000. Once you get to the office as a family, it's up to 20.
Sure.
You know, so if we have, you know, two that we have now, which we know what we have, and then that third one comes in, we don't know how that interest is going to play out for that third unknown. So it could be an $8,000 additional on top of that, or the $20,000 because of their health insurance plan, which we have to eat.
Okay.
You know, so there, basically what it is, there's too many unknowns to make a solid decision.
Between now and then, can we get a hold of the people at Bethel Township to see their ideas on this? Because that could be, we have known unknowns, and that could be a known known.
Sure.
So,
yeah.
Thank you.
Just to make a point also, our current deputies put in 71 hours last month of extra duty. So 71 hours in that month, that would be at least, I would think, another half deputy at that point, being out on our streets and so forth. So thank you again for all your extra time that you've put in. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Anybody else? Anything else you'd like to say on that? Okay. So, we're finished with the city manager's report?
Oh, yeah, we're done with city manager.
Yes? Okay. Communications. Oh, I'm sorry, we've already done that. It's now time for comments from members of the public. Anyone here like to speak today? Yes, sir. You're going up to the podium. Identify yourself. Thank you.
Ronald Cobb, 202 Villa Drive. I know you're going to get mad at me, and I don't care. When you pass these flyers out, you guarantee four deputies if the levy passed. You had Bill Lindsay and a few other people going around door to door telling the same thing. If the levy passed, you would bring four deputies, not three and a half. Now, either you're going to bring the four deputies back or you're going to be a bunch of liars. That's what it's coming down to. You're not going to get your share of deputy out of Bethel Township. Bethel Township. They don't want it. You rent a debt, or you call it, what is that, the $25 an hour, where you pay no benefits, Mr. Burke?
They're called extra duty.
Okay.
Extra duty.
You have no guarantee if you go to that through the sheriff that you'll have that duty covered at the $25 an hour. Bethel Township pays $35 an hour, so they're guaranteed to get that shift covered. And I'm not saying we gotta spend more money. What we need is a conserve, but we gotta get the four deputies back that you promised. We keep throwing money away in some areas. I know you're tired of hearing about the school. We can't sell it, we can't give it away. Why don't the city demolish it itself?
Was the last
hundreds of thousands of dollars, Mr.
Yeah, the last money, $185,000, I think, was the last amount that we had
years ago.
That was quite a few years ago.
But there again, you're running into the same problem.
I understand, sir.
Previous council bought the building, yes, I'll agree with that. But it still falls on you people to do something with it. Yes, Randy can't, Mr. Bridge cannot tell me what the contract will be, neither can Gene Kelly, Deputy Chief Wright can't tell me. But the bottom line, when it comes down to you printed something put out on people's doors.
Yes, sir, I understand that, but we just went over we went the way we went at the moment. We can't say give us four deputies January 1st when we don't have the money, Mr. Cobb, at that point.
But you should.
But hopefully we will get there.
You should not have put this out and said that we'd be back to normal with the four deputies.
That doesn't say January 1st.
What it says, it will pay the salaries, health insurance for four deputies and return the city back to normal police protection.
And Ron, let me jump in here too, if I may.
Go ahead, please.
I want four deputies just as much as you do, because I agree with exactly what you're saying. But I mean, you and everyone else has to realize, it, you know, just like Randy said and what the mayor said is that money, you've got to at least wait till the money comes in before you spend it. You can't spend money you don't have.
Yeah, but you should not have even put this out that you would bring four deputies back.
What if we do that?
Are we going, like Mr. Zambach says, we're going to wait till 2017 before we can decide if we got, if we can have a fourth deputy?
That's not my plan. Now, I want that fourth deputy back, and that's what I'm going to be going for.
And nothing against this young lady here. She's doing extra time out here where that money is not being wasted, don't get me wrong, but that money can be going towards another deputy, or towards the, yeah.
I don't know what you're trying to say.
The $25 an hour deal.
Extra duty.
Extra duty. You know.
Mr. McIntyre, is it
fun? Address what you have to say here. I'm all for the four deputies as well. I wasn't at the work session or special meeting when we decided on the three, but it looks like it's going to be three now, and we're going to be getting a contract that's going to give us the definite prices, and we don't know the definite prices with health insurance. I think once we get those definite prices, I know at least I'll push for it, is to look at how much it's going to cost per deputy and see how much it would cost to add that additional fourth deputy. And maybe we can have the city manager crunch some numbers, or maybe ask if we can get an addendum to the contract to say, hey, if in 2 weeks we can all get together and do whatever we do and find it for a fourth deputy, can we add that on there? Or do we have an option of submitting another separate contract aside from the three so we can have a contract for three and a contract for one? Because it isn't something that's set in stone that we're, you know, can never rectify or never change. I think once we have the numbers, at least I'm going to push for an idea of having another way where we can get another deputy on there or have another contract for a single deputy. I think that's the best way we can go about handling this.
Mr. Cobb, I'm all for 24/7 deputies for the city of New Carlisle. To be able to get to that point, we would have to have quite a bit more money. This extra duty is a great way to help supplement that at this time. That's the reason that we've been doing that. And our deputies at this point, I just told you, 71 hours they put in last year.
And that's 71,
last month, rather,
and that 71 hours of unscheduled hours, so people
right,
don't
exactly.
know when they're
people don't know if they're on or off.
I'm not arguing that with the extra duty. She's doing a fine job. And so in the other one.
You've heard the whys and why nots at this point that we have it or we don't have the money to continue on to say, let's put on four deputies in January. We won't have the money for four. In fact, it's going to be tough to cover three at that point.
What I'm trying to tell you have told the citizens that you will bring four deputies back.
I understand the piece
and of the citizens are under the assumption that you will bring them back in the first year.
And that's exactly what we're attempting to do when we have the money to do that.
But what I'm trying to tell you had this gentleman out here telling people door to door, you had other people telling you posted flyers with the same thing. People in this town are under the assumption, January 1, we're going to have four deputies.
Well, it was a wrong assumption that they were, because the money's
council
not there.
Council said right up there and said the same thing, they were going to have four deputies back.
Who said that, please?
Mr. McIntyre said.
I'm in favor of it. I want to push for four deputies.
In a meeting, you stated with this levy, we would bring four deputies back.
And with the time limit, the time on it, we don't know until the money comes in. You can see that.
Right, I see that, but you've got to understand tell you one thing.
And we definitely plan on doing that.
You know, you're not going to get your sheriff deputy with Bethel Township. They don't want it.
We don't know that for sure.
Well, I do. I sit in meetings.
Okay.
You know, you got 400 hours allocated for the extra duty deputy, correct, Mr. Bridge?
I don't know the total number. I mean, you did that months ago.
I believe you said 400 hours for the extra duty deputy.
For coming up in 2016? Forward or
when you discussed when you had discussed it with council, the extra
at
duty.
At some point in time, there was a number given. What that number
at the $25 an hour, it estimated out to 400 hours what you would have.
Okay.
Which will take, 2 months to eat that up?
Depends on how frequently they pick up shifts.
Mr. Cobb, you've heard from all seven of us up here and the city manager that we would like to have four deputies back. But it's a time situation.
Mr. Cobb, I think your heart's in the right place. I think you're a little too early for this debate right now. I think that once we have a little bit more of this money in, and then they're not holding up to the four persons for it, then I think you should be up there saying what you're saying now. Right now, it's just way too early. It's just way too early. I mean, there's just no way, shape, or form out of this. We do not know. There's too many unknowns. Everybody in this room would love to get it back to four deputies.
So I'd like to have...
Everybody would. I don't think anybody is not debating that. But until we have a little bit more solid information in front of us, I think that would be your time to come and say, this is what we need. I wouldn't take it to account. I think Bethel Township, it might entertain sharing a deputy. They may or not. I don't know. I'm not in their heads. But a lot of people, even we need to realize, we could pay for that fourth deputy, but that fourth deputy can be down in Bethel Township a lot more than what we like, and we can't do anything about it.
Disagree.
Well, you can take that with Gene Kelly.
I'm going to be straight up with you.
Because if there is a call down in Park Lane, do you guys not respond?
I've fought this battle before, and I can't win it, but it's sure. Wrong is if we pay for a deputy, it ends up down there.
They pay for a deputy that ends up here. Gene Kelly has a patrol car in the area that ends up here. At
Mr.
the end
Cobb,
of the day...
I'm sorry, Randy, that's gentlemen, a different thing, but...
Sure.
Gentlemen, we've gone around this a number of times. Mr. Cobb, we're way over your 5 minute. If you would, please, if you'd step down and see if somebody else would like... Thank you.
Well,
for all your comments, we appreciate it.
There is a petition out to recall that 0.5%. I will let you know that.
All right, sir. I hope that doesn't happen because then we're going to be in real trouble with that.
Then we'll probably be in fiscal watch.
Yeah.
Then we'll be in fiscal watch. So if the citizens
want
to repeal that, let me.
Let's go on. Okay, if we can, Mr. Lowry. All right, please. All right.
I'm going to ask it before the meeting. Okay, one way or another.
All right, no problem. Anybody else like to speak? Yes, ma'am. If you're going up and identify yourself, give your address, please.
My name's Nancy Lubanovich at 505 Pease Drive. I don't consider this a debate, what we're doing here. We understand what you're telling us fully. The problem is, you didn't tell us this before you had the vote for that levy. It was understood by everybody in New Carlisle, except you people, that we were going to have four deputies at the start of the year. Number two, we needed a deputy way before that. Not just the four, but a fifth. We have a horrible, horrible heroin problem in this town that needs looked at. So right there, we could have used another deputy. If you can't find the money someplace, I think you need to dig a little bit harder. If we have to go into physical watch, maybe that's what we have to do. But I'm telling you guys, just for you guys to dance and say, oh, well, now, we can't do it until we do this, this, and this. This is something you should have said before the election, and I'll guarantee you three of you wouldn't be sitting up there. Okay?
Thank you for comments. Yes, Mr. Metcalf.
I just want to say this. To me, if anybody that voted on the levy, and this may make somebody mad, and I apologize, it's not to say that people don't understand what's going on, but it's no different than someone getting a job, and this is the simplest way to put it. And I want that fourth deputy just as bad as you do, Ron. I mean, I'm dead set. I don't want a half deputy with Bethel. I think that's just ridiculous. I want a fourth full-time deputy. But I'm one person. You can't start a job this week and go buy a Corvette or anything. You can't, you know, go buy your new flat screen until you get that paycheck. That's common sense. If you pass an increase in tax, you can't spend that money until you have it. It's just that simple. I mean, how are you going to spend something you don't have? And I'm not arguing. I'm just saying that's the basic logic behind it.
I'm saying we understand what you're saying.
Right.
It should have been said before.
But I would think that people would understand that.
Nobody understood it.
Why wasn't this brought up at the work session? We had a whole dedicated work session about the police stuff. None of anybody, and I'm not saying it's right or wrong, but nobody voiced concerns then. And I was a planning director during this last year. And we had a very open, honest discussion at the work session. So if you're here, Now, I was here as a planning director when all this levy stuff was going around, and there was a lot of talk about bringing the Ford back. But I'm almost positive Ms. Hires spoke with it if it brings back. I know our former city manager spoke with it if it comes back the way that they wanted it to come back as far as the dollar amounts. The money doesn't come in. The money doesn't come in. You know, you can look at it like, you know, this council's trying to get things over on the citizens. That's not the truth. The council, what we're doing now, everything now is a living, breathing thing. We'll know what money we have coming in. If we can do it, I'm not putting the city in fiscal watch over the deputy. That is the worst. That is, you don't do that. You know, if we have to go to three deputies to stay out of fiscal watch, then I'm going to recommend that to council. Because once you go into fiscal watch, it's a whole different world of state takeover.
I'm staying with someplace else.
You know, there's nothing left. You know, once we get the money coming in, like I said, there's just too many unknowns. We're arguing, I mean, we're debating about stuff that we just don't know the answers to. Again, this is a very valid concern that both of you have. I just think it's a little premature. I think we need to wait.
Okay.
That's all. I have no other recommendations to make.
Thank you. Anybody else in the audience? Anybody else like to say something? Yes, sir. If you go up to the podium.
My name is William Lindsay. 314 North Henry Street. I've heard a lot of talk about the levy. I've heard a lot of talk about the four deputies. I've talked to Gene Kelly numerous times about the police protection here in New Carlisle. He says we need nine deputies to give this town 24/7 protection. At nine deputies, we would have to have, I would say, $1.5 million income a year just to support the deputies. The way I took the special meeting, because I have the minutes on it, that it was voted on and passed, and the contract was going to be for three deputies come January. I did not read anything in the minutes that it would be a possible open to bring a fourth deputy on in, say, 6 months or at some point next year.
Mr. Lindsay, the minutes from that meeting are not even finished. So I don't know how you have them.
I thought you sent them to me.
No, you have the minutes from the last council meeting.
Okay, well then, sorry. maybe it was, I was on drugs when I read them.
I didn't want to go any further with that.
The three deputies, if we have the money to get those three, starting the first of the year, the money that we are paying now for deputies will go to where? General fund?
Excuse me, what was the question?
The money we're paying for deputies right now for this year, starting January 1, will go to general fund because the police levy money?
It will ease up the general fund, yes.
Okay. Would it be possible to have money from the general fund to support that fourth deputy until the money comes in from the levy? It'd be like borrowing money from yourself and then replace that money.
That might be difficult because we can't take money out of the police fund to reimburse the general fund.
Yeah, that is a problem.
The money for that 0.5% can only be used
for
police protection. Only, period.
Billy, we're gonna look at creative ways to get this done. Again, I think this debate is just too early. I have no other excuse, I have no other answer to say until we have the figures in front of us. We're gonna make, right now it's all speculation.
Yeah.
I mean, it's exactly what it is.
The contract you have now before Kelly, Sheriff Kelly, is it strictly for three or are you asking
the
what
one
the
we're
cost?
Operating currently right now is
right.
For two.
No, I meant for
upcoming
2016, the upcoming
is for,
one.
Is for three.
Can you get figures on that fourth deputy from him?
He's already going to give it to us.
No, he won't give it to you?
He's already going to give us. We're here to give it to us. At that work session there, we have the cost for three deputies. Yeah. We have all the information presented to us. If we're going to have three deputies, we can just add a fourth. What they get paid is the same.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it really comes down to that health insurance coverage. Right. Do they need single family or they need a family coverage? And
Mr. Lindsay, we also don't know what the health will be until we have the deputy in place, whoever bids for for the job.
Right.
They have to bid for the job. You know that.
Depends if they're single or.
So whoever bids for the job, whether it's family man, single person, whatever it may be, that affects quite a bit on what the pay will be for that particular person. Mm-hmm. How much the contract would be.
Right.
For that year.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you.
Colleen?
I do want to commend all the council up there tonight, because all of you spoke up and you all said you wanted that fourth deputy.
Oh, we did.
I did not get that feeling a few months ago from all of council, but I'm glad that all of you wants to do that.
Ms. Harris, with what Mr. Lindsay had said, and that was kind of what I was wondering myself, was could the general fund for a year 2016 sustain 92,000, if that's what the cost is for one deputy, because you're still saving 92,000 from one, but you see what I'm saying, you're saving the cost of two. Can we do the savings of just one and still pay for one full deputy out of the general fund, if I got that to you right?
It's not our intention at this time to take that general fund money and put to the police. The levy was for the police to fund, and as we collect, you know, we will be able to increase as we have it. The general fund, if you remember, was very, very close to going in fiscal watch. It needs its money back. There is no available. Yes, we might not be spending the money that we're spending for the sheriff, but the general fund loans for the water, the sewer, the streets, the everything, and it's got to build its own reserve. It has to go back to getting positive. So the intent is exactly what we're doing. It's just, let us get this money collected. Let us get the three police that the manager's working on. And as we get it collected that first quarter, we're gonna have some really good numbers to work with to see where it's going, how well it's coming in, and what we want to do at that point. But the general fund needs to get strong right now. And I
do you think it could, and I don't know, you'd have to run the numbers, could the general fund sustain doing it for 1 year and 1 year only?
We'd have to look at it in detail. It's just not there right now.
That's a budget that we're going to be looking at here in the next month or two also. We have to take a look.
Council members need to realize that general fund needs to get healthy. And it needs to get healthy.
I understand. Right.
The general fund for years upon years have been supporting other funds or enterprise funds in this city. But, and it needs to get back to what a general fund needs to be.
But my thought is if we could sustain doing the fourth deputy with the general fund for 1 year, and then at that time, in the beginning of 2017, the increase, the tax increase, should be, for the most part, in a full swing.
Yeah, but then the general funds out that money that they use to...
Right.
Yeah, you know, so, again, it's all speculation. Yeah. I think
Mr.
we should
Lowry,
have this
you
conversation
wanted to say something, please?
Two.
Go ahead.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And several people have just touched on something that was what I was telling you that I was going to say before the meeting was over with regardless. You know, what's the old saying about hindsight, 2020?
Yeah.
And we all sat here. We can argue about it. I don't often agree with you, but 50-50. But, you know, he's right.
He can't hear you.
We sat here and said we was going to have four deputies. We didn't say we had to wait till the end of the year for the money to come in. Okay? We didn't do that. I don't care what anybody said. I said I'm never meeting. Okay. Nothing personal against you or anybody here, but facts are facts.
I wasn't the manager at the time.
Okay. We need to get the fourth deputy. Okay? If we had to go into the general fund, before we did this levy, we had, what was it, $238 or $328 left over at the end of the year, okay? I'm sure it's a little bit healthier than that right now. Maybe it will only be for 3 months that we have to pay for the fourth day. But we need to do it, and we need to do it soon.
Okay, that will probably not be done by the first of the year. I mean, I just don't see us having four deputies to start January 1.
I believe that the general fund will sustain it.
I think that we should, again, look at it after the first quarter. I think for the first 3 months, the citizens would understand us, definitely the city administration and the city council, doing their due diligence to make sure that this is what the direction we need to go, but more importantly, verifying that with the money we have coming in. We can go ahead and do it right now if you want, but tell you what, if we're negative,
It's not going to look good.
I don't think we're going to be negative. And I could be wrong, you know, but the thing of it is just like he said, she said, I don't agree with Gene Kelly and his 9 deputies covering nuclear lines. It's not going to stop the heroin problem. I don't care if he brings in 120, okay? Ain't going to happen. He's going to tell you what he wants you to hear.
He didn't say it to me.
Okay, yeah. You know, he's going to tell you what he wants you to hear. He would love to see 30 of them here, okay? He's the same guy that sat here and told us when we dropped the deputies, the response time would have changed, but it sure did, okay? It changed a whole lot. But when we put it out about the deputies and the money, we didn't do it right, okay? And when I say we, I'm talking about all of a sudden up there. We didn't say we wouldn't possibly get the fourth deputy until 2017.
Well, I want to know why somebody even said.
We didn't say we would.
Well, I want to know why it was even. I guess it's not. I don't want to know why, but we don't bring in over $1 million for income tax collection. So why it was promoted, you at least bring in 500,000. I have no idea.
We collect around
900,000 dollars.
That's what she said multiple times.
So.
Brought us figures.
Well, you guys have, everybody at the table up there has a copy of the budget.
If it brings in.
Whether it be 15, 16, 14, or 12. So you can look at that budget and see how much you bring on the income tax. So just as much as it's Kendra's responsibility to let you guys know, it was your responsibility to read that budget. So, but unless you saw over $1 million of income come in, simple math tells you you're not going to get $500,000.
I brought up several times that I don't do that.
Well, then you're never going to get $500,000 back.
Well, that was correct because of, you got a lot of retirements.
Sure.
And they bring in well, they don't.
Non-taxable.
Yeah, non-taxable. Mm-hmm. So, like I said, I just think this. Everybody here wants 4 deputies. We've got to make sure we can afford it.
Mr. McIntyre, would like to say something, please?
For the first of the year, when we have our meeting, next year, it's going to be coming up here in January, can you bring in some figures that say, here's estimated general fund, here's how much we think one deputy would cost, here's what a contract for one deputy, an extra deputy would look like, so we can look at that and say, yeah, it's something we can do, we can take a little bit out of the general fund, and when the money comes in, take that away and put it back in the general fund, you know, stop using it from the general fund. Can we just get something, so that way we can all look at it and we can have
everybody
a discussion
already
as a community.
Has those numbers.
I know, absolutely. But can this happen again in January?
Absolutely.
Thank you, sir.
Yep. I'll bring a copy of the tax budget. I will bring the figures we bought at the work session again. We can look at it. We can revisit the issue.
Okay, can we continue on?
Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Reynolds, go ahead.
I know that everyone's really upset because we were all promised 4 deputies. And I understand that, you know, the money has to come in for us to get those deputies. I just think that it's unfortunate because a lot of folks, seldom do I agree with Mr. Lowry, but this is a case where I do. I think everyone had the understanding that we were going to have 4 deputies January 1. I mean, there's actually an interview that I can recall where Kim Jones said, we will get our deputies back at the start of the year. It's on Channel 7, you go Google it online, you can find it. I mean, that's what we were told. And as counsel, she was our city manager, and we trusted her, and we believed that she was informing us of the right decision. It was wrong. And we now know that, and we're gonna address that in the coming year. I mean, Dick's lucky, he's gonna be out of here in less than, this is his last meeting. You know, I mean, but we're all up here, we're gonna have to deal with this one way or another.
Mr. Cobb, go ahead, please. We're going on. Sure, go ahead, please.
What is the contract?
December 31st.
Sheriff?
It ends December 31st of 2015. December 31st of 2015. You're asking about the current contract of 2015.
Okay, we're gonna continue
Mr.
on.
Mr. Mayor.
We've been on this for
30 seconds more and I'll shut up and we'll move
30 seconds. Yes, sir. Mr. Zander.
The contract for 3 deputies for next year does not lock us in to only 3 deputies.
Right.
The opportunity to expand upon that exists. So it doesn't mean there won't be but 3 deputies next year. It's the beginning of getting to 4. That's where it is. Step 1. I'm done.
Thank you, sir. All right, let's continue on. Thank you all for all the comments, everyone.
Yes.
We appreciate it. This is how we continue on.
Mr. Mayor, we have another comment.
Do we have one other person like to speak? Please, go ahead.
My name is Linda Eggleston Nowakowski. I live at 319 South Main Street for 2 years now. I lived here many, many years ago, and I did what lots of people do, went off to college and moved out of town. I've come back, and New Carlisle is not what it was when I was here before. There's no community, and the town is not sustainable. New Carlisle is now a food desert. The average age of the city is higher than the state average age. The average income is lower than the state average. I would like to at least think about ways that we can work together to change those things around. Some of those things involve looking at the kinds of businesses that we start to bring into New Carlisle and encouraging local business as opposed to big outside things that are just sucking our money right out of town. But that's a bigger thing than I want to deal with right now. What I'd like to deal with right now is ask the city if they can find a piece of land that we can build a community garden on. This would have the possibility of providing some fresh, free, essentially free produce for people who can't afford it and can't get it. It also has a possibility of building some community where people get together and start to talk to each other. And community is what will deal with the heroin problem. Starting to get people who are looking after their neighbors instead of looking after themselves. And talking and helping each other and making it a community where we live for each other, not just for ourselves. So what I am asking is if the council can consider giving us a piece of land that might come off of the Madison Street School property, across the driveway behind the houses between Clay and the school. So that's all I have to.
Linda, thank you. Thank you for coming.
Could you spell your last name? Not the Eggleston part.
NOWAKOWSKI.
Can you remember that?
It's very easy.
Thank you for comments, and we all agree with you, believe me. It's hard to get people to step forward to be on committees or to do extra things for the city, believe me. But I commend you, and I hope all that happens. I hope the garden happens. I know Mr. Krabacher has been working on that, and I'm sure that as long as we have a committee together to do it, it can come to fruition. So thank you for being here. Yes, go ahead, Mr. Krabacher.
One of the big, I'm on the starting committee, you know, with Linda, and we had a meeting the other day at the library, and I just want to, you know, say that on the 15th is the next meeting. Yes. You know, come to the meeting, and what, not this meeting, but the meetings after that, we have Ohio State Extension helping out.
Nice.
And we're trying to get enough people for the seed program. So that's a big thing. Master gardeners are going to get involved. We have, you know, some really good instruction to how to get started. And Linda's done, I think you've done this before. You have, you know, other places. And
yes,
been involved.
I'm in charge, have been in charge over the last year of the community garden in Donaldsville. It's on the property of the Rising Christ Community Church. I've applied for a grant from the National Lutheran Church for $6,000 a year for 2 years to build community gardens in the area, not just in New Carlisle, but covering West Milton and Donaldsville and Fairborn and New Carlisle.
So this thing is not, you know, I tried to do it off the seat of my pants, but for some reason, I hate to say, but God brought us together, really. We ended up in the same spot, talked about the same thing. We're like, wait a minute.
Well, thank you all for your hard work. Hopefully that comes from fruitation. We really hope it does and bring the community together. Thank you.
Mr. Mayor. I was at that meeting with Mr. Krabacher. Mr. Reynolds was there as well. I'm all for it. I love green initiatives. Sustainability is huge for me. You got to look at it just past a plot. Some of this food is, we're going to grow way much than anyone can ever eat. This is something that we can give back to our local food banks on, give to churches. I know Mr. Krabacher cooks a lot of meals for underprivileged people. So it's something that we are definitely going to look at. We did revisit, we'll revisit it. We had a little bit of discussion on it last year at the Madison School. A certain advisor to the city may not agree with it. We will reopen it because I think it is one of those things that need to be done. And yes, you're right. It is little things like that that start bringing community back together. So thank you guys for getting the effort started.
It needs to be done quickly.
Well,
because planting season is coming up.
Mr. Reynolds.
Like the same age that I was at that meeting, you guys had some folks there from Springfield who were talking about the gardens. I think it's a wonderful idea. I'm a huge supporter of urban agriculture and hope to see it really move. You know, I know John and I talked about it last year. I know that he really pushed the cart there, and now I'm happy you guys got connected so we can get this thing done. So thank you for your help and, you know, really pushing this as well.
Mr. McIntyre has comments.
You guys said you met at the library, and that reminded me of something that I heard about a half year ago. Some libraries, I think Huber Heights is doing this, they have a sort of a seed bank, and you can go there and you pull out the card catalog, which they don't use card catalogs anymore, but you pull it out and you can get different seeds. There you go.
This is the Ohio State Agricultural Extension, and if we set up the garden, they will give us the seeds.
There's some bias.
Okay, but if we're going to do that, they're giving us seeds. That means come February and March, we need to be planting seeds. So we need to know if we've got a piece of land so that we can.
That's going to be
easy part. We'll get it.
Getting the land. As long as the city owns it.
If you tell me I've got a piece of land, I'm going to go to this man and it's going to make front page paper. Some way it's going to make front page paper.
When we get to that point, we'll get Mr. Grimm involved, absolutely.
Thank you again for being here. We appreciate it. Anyone else in the audience like to speak? Anyone at all? Okay, thank you. We're going to move on, if you would. We've got we have the agenda tonight. Many reports, none tonight.
None.
Let's go into resolutions, if you would, please.
Resolution 15-09R, public hearing in action tonight. A resolution adopting new income tax rules and regulations effective January 1, 2016.
Mr. Mayor,
yes.
Move to adopt resolution 15-09R. Very much. Just an explanation of this resolution. As it was read, the state of Ohio had changed some tax rules and regulations. Since they changed that, our rules and regulations, the 2015 will remain in effect, but then we're going to have some new ones coming in for 2016 and beyond. And that's just this resolution is establishing those new rules beginning January 1, 2016. I do have our income tax administrator, Ms. Vicki, here. She'd be here to answer any questions that we may have. So thank you for taking time out of your evening to join us.
Any questions for tax administrator on this? We'll wait until we go to the ordinance.
We'll wait until we get to the ordinance.
And I will remind council this is a state thing we decided.
Right, I understand. Yeah. Any comments, anyone at all? Would you call for the vote?
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher?
Yes.
Passes 7-0.
Thank you. When you're ready, if you would go on, please.
Resolution 15-10R, public hearing in action tonight. Condemning the terrorist attacks in Paris and offering thoughts and prayers for the victims. condolences to their families and show support for the country of France and American ally.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
Move we adopt resolution 15-10R.
Second.
And an explanation to this resolution is just taking a moment to condemn the terrorist attacks and then also just offer our thoughts, prayers for the victims of the Paris attack.
Council, any questions? Yes, sir. Mr. Mayor.
Hopefully it's the last time we have to do something like this, but I don't think it will be, but let's hope.
I know that I had talked to the city manager about this, and we did this in 2013 for the Boston bombings, and I think it's something that we need to continue to be vigilant, and if you see things that are not necessarily normal or out of the norm, definitely call your local authorities, because a lot of this stuff can be stopped by that. It's an absolute terrible thing, and you know, France is definitely our oldest ally. They gave us the funds and the ammunitions to fight for our independence, and we definitely need to stand with them, because I think that this attack is showing an attack on democracy and a republic, and we need to say, you know, not only will this attack fail, but all attacks by terrorism will fail in the future.
Thank you. Anyone else? Should we call for the vote, please?
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Prebach?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Passes 7-0.
You. And when you're ready, if you would go on, please.
Ordinance 15-48, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance amending the estimated resources of the City of New Carlisle to the Clark County Auditor that will be available to appropriate for the fiscal year beginning January 1, 2015.
Gotcha.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion to adopt ordinance 15-48.
Second.
And just an explanation to this ordinance. This ordinance increases our estimated resources for 2015 due to the loans the city acquired for the water meter upgrade and the backhoe purchase.
Any questions, guys? Comments?
And these are just housekeeping.
Can you call for the vote, please?
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mrs. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Krabach?
Yes.
Pass 7-0.
Thank you. And when you're ready, please.
Ordinance 15-49, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance supplementing certain appropriations in ordinance 15-11E of the City of New Carlisle.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
Move we adopt ordinance 15-49.
Second.
And an explanation, this ordinance raises our expenditures for 2015 for the funds listed below in the ordinance and allows us to appropriate money to those funds.
Any questions, Council? Comments? Okay, Mr. Collier, if you call for the vote.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Krabach?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Pass 7-0.
Thank you.
Ordinance 15-50, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance establishing temporary appropriations for fiscal year 2016.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
Make a motion to adopt ordinance 15-50.
Second.
And just a quick explanation, this ordinance will allow the city to operate until the formal 2016 budget is adopted in the coming months.
Council, any questions, comments?
Did you make the second on that, Mr. Reynolds?
I did not.
No, Mr. Zambach. When you're ready, if you'll call for the vote, please.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Krabach?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Pass 7-0.
Again?
Give me a second.
Are you ready?
Ordinance 15-51, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance of the City of New Carlisle, Ohio, amending the disconnection reconnection fees, Appendix A of Ordinance 13-07, correcting Shrivener's error and providing for inclusion in the codified ordinances.
Mayor.
Yes, sir.
Motion to adopt Ordinance 15-09.
Second.
And just let me start off with, a lot of people don't know what a Shrivener's error is. Basically, it's a clerical error that was not supposed to happen. With the council version of these packets, I actually attached 1307. But if you flip to the last page of this, 1307, under the disconnection reconnection fees, you can see that line item one was striked out. It wasn't supposed to be striked out. It was supposed to remain. And that can be further evidenced by the title not being scratched out as well. Since I was the only item in that, if they're going to get rid of that part, the title should have been gone as well. Looking back at the history on the former city manager's computer, what I can get from it is she was working with our former law director, and we can see that there's quite a bit of changes on that. I just think the communication between the two, it wasn't cleared up that wasn't supposed to be on there. So we're just basically just correcting that and then putting it back on.
Comments, questions? Call for the vote, please.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Passed 7-0.
Thank you.
Ordinance 15-53E, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance amending Part 8, Business Regulation, Title 4, Taxation in Chapter 880, Income Tax to include an effective date and declared an emergency.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
Move we adopt Ordinance 15-53E.
Second.
Was that the second motion?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Just an explanation of this ordinance. First off, it's an emergency council, so we do need 6 votes to pass it. This is a state mandated thing, but this particular ordinance, what it does is it says that our Chapter 880 that was in effect for 2015 year and prior, that will stay the same. And Vicki, please stop in and correct me if I'm wrong on any of this, but this also goes on to just, they dictate that our current 880 is not good after 2016 essentially, but it's still going to remain on the books.
Well, it's through tax year 15.
Through tax year 15. Thank you.
Thank you for clearing that. Any questions, council, comments? We call for the vote, please.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Zambach?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Passed 7-0. Ordinance 15-54E, public hearing in action tonight. An ordinance establishing Chapter 881.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, sir.
Move we adopt ordinance.
He didn't finish reading.
Let me start that over. Ordinance establishing Chapter 881, income tax effective for tax years beginning January 1, 2016 and beyond, of the City of New Carlisle codified ordinances and declaring an emergency.
Mr. Mayor, move we adopt Ordinance 15-54E.
Second.
In explanation of this ordinance, this just establishes our Chapter 881 for the income tax beginning 2016 and beyond.
Council, any questions?
Is that right?
Comments? Any comments? Tax Administrator, any comments?
Okay.
Can I make a comment?
Yes, please do.
I want to give the most thanks I could possibly give. Our tax administrator has bent over backwards and has done this. This was not an easy project to do. When you overhaul your tax rules and regulations, it needs to be done, and it needs to be done correctly. And we have an employee here that has went above and beyond her duty to get this done in time. So on record, I could not thank you enough for the many hours of evening hours that you put in to get this city where it needs to be.
Thanks, Randy.
No problem.
And I'll get the kudos for also on the weekend. I've seen her there on the weekends going at it also.
Many.
Everybody would want an employee like this one.
Amen to that. Thank you so much for all your hard work.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Council, any questions? If you would please, call for the vote.
Mr. Rick Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher.
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry.
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin.
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre.
Yes.
Mr. Zambach.
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds.
Yes.
Ordinance 15-55, introduction tonight, public hearing in action on 12-21-15. An ordinance amending section 1040, water of the codified ordinances of the city of New Carlisle regarding billing. That's all I have, Mayor.
All right. Other business?
That is enough.
Council, any other business?
Yes.
I want to thank everyone for coming out on Saturday to our Christmas tree lighting ceremony. We had a small crowd, about 50 people, but it was a good turnout for 2 weeks, and a lot of people complimented the tree, said it was really beautiful. So I want to thank everyone for coming out, and definitely thank Marshall for the Christmas parade. This is our first year. Yes, a lot of learning to do, but it'll get better. I'm confident in that. So
I think by far that's probably our best looking Christmas tree that we've had.
Oh.
And I can remember the shape of it and the decorations. And I know we had somebody that donated it from Park Lane, I believe.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's where they came from.
Yep. They came to the ceremony.
Yes, they did.
Oh, wonderful. Yep. That's great. Well, that tree looks absolutely fabulous. The parade was great, except it was cold.
Oh.
I don't like this.
You should have worn a thicker jacket.
How about if we have it in
July? Christmas in July, there we go.
The farmer's market does that, so you might have a little competition.
Oh, but yes, it was great. And good participation, yes.
I want to commend Dale. You know, you get a beating sometimes, but you got a really neat article, I think it was last week, about the snowstorm, you know? And one of the things it says in the snowstorm, they were talking about neighbors getting out and helping each other, businesses even, you know, helping out with their tractors, helping out with their trucks, you know, moving the snow out of the way so the city could survive. You know, and there were several people in there that was named that article. As a matter of fact, I happened to know before they passed away, you know, which was Wilmer Funderburg and Gerald Studebaker, two of the finest men I've ever met in my life, you know. Very, very good.
That was a storm of 1950.
Yeah.
Just to let everyone know.
Do you remember that?
Did he?
I was alive then. I was. As a matter of fact, I had a hard time trying to get through the drifts.
But
Nick was alive then also.
And I remember that snow. And by golly, it seemed like it was up
it
to
was.
Here.
It was. It was up to here.
You guys are going to start telling us you walked to school over in the snow too, through brick beds and all that stuff as well. And what's next?
That was a great snow. We didn't go to school during that.
My Buell wouldn't even come out of the garage to get me going, right?
That's funny.
Okay, other business. Anyone else? Any other? Yes, sir.
I got one. I'd like to make a final comment. This is my last council meeting. I've had a great 12 plus years, and I sincerely thank the voters of New Carlisle for allowing me to represent the citizenry of New Carlisle, and I always tried to do the best I could for the city of New Carlisle, which is all of us that you see here. So thank you very much for the privilege.
It's always been very nice. Anyone else? Yes.
Mr. Mayor, I had a question for Mr. Zambach. Why will you not be at the last meeting of the year in December?
Because I'll be someplace else at that moment in time.
We'll be
going to work.
So he'll need to be excused?
Actually, at this point, I think it will be moot.
I will. Say, because I wasn't going to vote to excuse you.
Would you like to speak
right. They can fire.
Yeah, real quick in a minute. But real quick, Dick, since this is your last meeting, I just want to say thank you for everything you've done. You were, and I hope this doesn't sound cheesy, but I've always referred to Dick as being kind of like the Yoda of our group. Because seriously, when we get into our rants and we start to argue, Dick is always the one that kind of grabs us and pulls us back and says, you need to look at it at this light. And just, you've done a great job, so thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, well, yes, sir.
I've sat next to Dick now for 2 years. When I first got on council, he came up to me and he said, welcome. He's like, it's going to be a rough 4 years, but I think we'll be good, ready for it. And definitely has been. I know that he's, like you said, to coin a phrase, the Yoda of this city council. I know that he definitely works hard for the citizens and people really appreciate him. And like you said, he's a level-headed one. I think that there's been times that we've all gone after each other over different things throughout this last 4 years. And he's the guy that says, hey, for like Bill and I, we're on the far left and the far right here. We go at it sometimes and he'll just say, black or white, this is how it is. And I appreciate that. I'm definitely going to miss you. So
thank you.
Yes, sir. Mr. Rackman.
Yeah, the Zambox have known me since I was a snot-nosed kid, and now that I'm a snot-nosed adult, they're still willing to put up with me. And I got it just, like everyone said, Mr. Zambox here, he's not only the voice of reason, but he's able to find the exact right words, the exact right argument that we're all looking for.
Yep.
There's times where we debate, and he says, what you want is right here. This is the big picture. And as soon as he says it, everyone kind of goes, okay, well, you know, that's settled and that's done. And we're really going to miss him. He's a great guy, so thank you for your years of service.
Okay.
Anyone else? Yes, sir.
Yeah. I as well would just like to say thank you. I know that you have always been at least 120% pro New Carlisle. That's what you was here for. You mm-hmm. spent 12 years and you was always for New Carlisle. I'm, like I say, over the top. I have only one time in all the years I've known you ever called and you couldn't answer, and that's when Jeanette said you was taking a nap. But any other time, he was always there, and you always had the right answers, and you know. And I thank you, Dick. I appreciate it.
Right.
I wish you nothing but the best. Stop by and see me sometime.
Anyone else? Any other comments?
He knows where I live, so.
Dick, again, thank you so much. Really, we're going to miss you. I said level-headed, and I meant that. Very level-headed. It goes a long way. Common sense goes a long way in trying to settle problems. And you've done a great job of that.
We should listen to one another.
Yes, amen. And enjoy your semi-retirement.
Thank you.
And we'll play some golf. Maybe.
Outside
not right
chance.
Now, summertime. Okay. Shall we go on with the other business? Would you like to read
sure.
that way, sir?
Sure. City offices will be closed on Christmas Eve, Thursday, December the 24th, Christmas Day, Friday, December the 25th, New Year's Day, Friday, January 1st, 2016, and the city offices will be closed at noon on 12/18/15. What day of the week is that?
Friday.
On a Friday, we'll close at noon for the employee Christmas party. No crime watch meetings during December. They'll resume in January 2016. And here on the agenda, we have last meeting tonight for Councilmember Dick Zambach, but we already covered that, so that's all I have.
Thank you. I would like to just say, Mr. Lindsay, I'm glad to see you here and you're up and moving around, and I'm glad to see that. I know you were hurting for a while. Good to see you out and about.
I'm improving, and you tell me every day somebody's not wondering
about. Good to hear. Anything else? Anybody else? Anything?
Yeah, I got one last thing, and
yes,
this is
go
different.
Ahead.
Jeanette came to council meeting tonight, my wife, and I would be remiss if I did not mention that Wednesday of next week we will be celebrating our 54th wedding anniversary.
Wow. Good here. Executive session, there's none tonight.
For the very last time in many, many years, I move we adjourn.
We are adjourned.